Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today, in this video, we are going to use the quad warp effect to create this picture replacement in HitFilm Express. So this is actually a very super easy effect to do, and it really demonstrates the power of the free version of HitFilm Express that you have right at your fingertips to be able to do something really cool in a very, very simple and easy fashion. So I have my raw footage here. It's about 17 seconds. I'm going to right-click on it and just say, make a composite shot, clicking OK. And you can see that I have the picture in the background hanging on the wall. And what I want to do is I want to put the other picture over the top of it. So to do that, I will need to track each of the four corners of this picture. So I'm going to open up the footage, and under tracks, the very first item, I'm going to hit this little plus icon that says insert tracker. And it moves me from the viewer tab to the layer tab, because you will need to be viewing the layer only to be able to see the tracker. Using my mouse wheel, I'm going to scroll in a little bit, and I can grab my tracking device inside of the little red box, and I will just drag it up here until it is over the corner. And I can zoom in very, very, very closely, all the way up to 800%, as you can see down here. And then I can just place that exactly on the corner. I'm going to place the track marker exactly on the corner. I might bring in the red box a little bit and bring in the green box a little bit. And then when I'm ready, I can go ahead and go back out. And then I can just hit the play button forward. And what you will see is that it will begin tracking. It's scrubbing through the timeline, and it is tracking. It is marking each point that it is tracking on with a blue track marker. And you'll see here in a second as I move it, you can see exactly where the tracks were all the way. This was a handheld shot, so therefore this shot genuinely is moving all the time and would be very, very difficult to track in a manual fashion. Okay, so now what I will do, now that the track is over, I can go ahead and go back to the beginning, and I can highlight that tracker and hit my F2 key to rename it. I'm going to rename it lower right. So this indicates the lower right portion of the picture. Then what I will do is I will go ahead and track the other three, and I will do that and be right back. So now you can see that I have tracked all four of those points. What I will do now is create a new point, and I'm going to, using my F2 key, rename that to upper right. And then I will duplicate it, making four different points that have each of those four points covered. Now that I have created a point for each corner of the picture, I will open up my trackers, and one at a time I will click on it, and under the track tab I will purpose of transform layer to the corresponding layer. So the lower right, I will go to the lower right, and I will click apply. And now that has applied those position data points to the lower right, and you can see them all here. So now I'm going to do the same for all of the other points. Now that I have applied all of the tracking data to the four points, if I were to go ahead and highlight all four of those and then play this, you can see that those points are following exactly along with the tracking points on the four corners of the picture. And this will allow me to apply the quad warp effect to the picture that I'm going to add here. So what I will now do is come back out to my media bin and find my picture. This is a picture of Deep Space Nine, my favorite Star Trek show. I'm going to just bring this in, and then I'm going to search for and find the quad warp effect, dragging this onto the Deep Space Nine picture. If I open it up, you'll see that I have four different points: top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right. I'm going to open up top left, and I'm going to say use the top left or upper left and it now is going to assign that directly to that point. And then top right will go to the upper right, and bottom left will go to the lower left, and bottom right will go to the lower right. And so now you can see that that picture has been latched on there. And if I were to play this, you can see that even though the camera is now moving, the picture itself is locked into place on the wall next to the other picture where the old picture used to be, right? And it's really that simple. Now, if I wanted to, and I probably would, right now there is no reflection on the glass. And so to add to the realism, what I did was I created a reflection on the glass. And here's how I did it. I cheated. I went ahead and just said, well, this is pretty good. I basically am looking for the window. So I'm going to right click on the raw footage and say duplicate it. And then I'm going to rename that reflection. And I will go ahead and bring it above the Deep Space Nine. You can see now it has covered it. But what I'm going to do is just grab this quad warp effect and copy it and paste it directly onto the reflection. So now basically it looks like it is, it's actually the same video on there, and you can tell, but you can sort of see the windows here, and you know the windows there, and I thought, man, that looks pretty good. And all I'm going to do is take the transform and knock that down to about 20% or so. So there's a little bit of a reflection there, and you can see that little bit of a reflection, and as the camera moves, it moves inside there, and it's not exactly correct, but it certainly makes it look realistic enough that you wouldn't be able to notice unless you were really carefully examining it, that it's not the actual reflection inside of that window. So pretty much in a nutshell, that is how you can use the quad warp effect to do a picture replacement in your shot. You can do this on a television screen or a monitor. There's lots of other things you can do. It is very simple to do. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.